What a fantastic performance by TDK Makassette. We'll catch up with her later. 10 more days of Women's Month left. Ladies, make sure you squeeze it for all it's worth. Like 46-year-old Ben Affleck, for example. I mean, he's been spotted with 22-year-old Playboy model Shauna Sexton amid speculation of his relationship with Saturday Night Live producer Lindsay Shookus. Well, when I Ben, you definitely shook us dating a young girl called Sexton. Well, I can't imagine you having a ton of sex with her, though, without a little help for a magic blue pill. Sticking with the nasty, a leaked chat between Elon Musk's musician girlfriend Grimes and trouble-seeking rapper Azalea Banks has set the internet alight. In the chat, among other things, Grimes alludes to Elon having a giant package. Now, a couple of months ago, Elon launched a rocket into space called the Falcon Heavy. I wonder where he got the name for that.
Well, I don't know, Tumi, but I just can't wait for the ad break, because after this drink, which is my third of the night, my Falcon feels extremely heavy.
Hey! Wow, TMI, Glenn, thank you. No, thank you. But you know what else felt heavy? That Italian bridge that collapsed last week. Weird, because the Leaning Tower of Pisa, one of Italy's wonders, has been standing for centuries with us just waiting for it to go poof. It's like that drunk guy who never falls, but then the designated driver crashes his car. I mean. Anyway, moving along, two-time Academy Award-winning actor and suspended sexual predator Kevin Spacey's latest film, Billionaire Boys Club, has raked in a mere 1,800 rands in its opening weekend. My friend, you know it's cack when it's that much in rands. Yeah, ne? Maybe they should just change the title. Someone who's keeping his title, though, is the mayor of Nelson Mandela Bay, Ethel Trollope. He has survived another motion of no confidence. Feels like deja vu. Obviously, he uses the same sangoma as this guy. On the trouble front, A deputy principal in KZN, a whole deputy principal, is being investigated for allegedly using a dead teacher's qualifications to land senior posts in the Department of Education. Now, personally, I don't understand why a person would do that unless they themselves are brain dead. But imagine working that hard all your life only to have someone steal your degree when you die. I would totally haunt you, Branka Upokela. Seriously, I would appear to you in the most inopportune times, like when you're lecturing, and then suddenly you just see a hand come up in the lecture room on some, ma'am, can you show us your graduation pictures? Right, on the wedding front, check out this romantic video of a couple that went viral recently. Was about to a knockout wedding night. Hey, we have a great show tonight. It's all about the world of blogging, social media, entrepreneurs. And all of that, we have bloggers Lelo Boyana and Melody Molale on the couch. Our Who's That Girl feature focuses on Baby Caramel, who is a transgender activist and model. But first, Leng, what's the WTF of the day?
Thank you so much, Tumi. Happy Tuesday to every single one of you watching. Thanks for tuning in. The WTF today is Why the Foul? British boxer Billy Joe Saunders was chased out of a very popular chicken restaurant after throwing chicken at an American fighter, DeAndre Wilder, in Belfast. Personally, I'm not disappointed in him. I just think, what are a grown bunch of sportsmen doing having a chick fight? It makes no sense.
Hold on. So a white man throwing a chicken at a black man. Why is he offended? I mean, it's like throwing condoms at a sex addict.
Oh, yeah, that's like throwing tears at Donald.
Yes. It's like throwing DJ Zinklat, AKA.
Ah, it's like me throwing penises at you. No, because you... No. Okay.
And like on trailer fail, eh? It's time for a break. Lelo Boyana joins us when we return. I'm shocked. There's a Caucasian dude who made a fox pass in the socials. I think Azania will be banning. Sorry, let's not get angry. There are very few idiots in this world. We'll mute them. Welcome back to hashtag WTF to me. Do the right thing and hit us up on the socials. The handle is at WTF to me. We're about to get into some good times. So let's welcome my first guest. She is the brains behind Just Curious and Chica, a blogger and an influencer. Ladies and gents, welcome Lelo Boyana. What is the lovely Lelo sipping there?
So Lelo is the original queen of gossip, although Ooh. She has retired now, but I still had to make her a royal cup of tea. And I do hope you spill some tonight, darling, if you don't mind.
I'm in retirement, so...
Which is why I bought you the royal. Exactly.
Okay. You sounded like
Thank you.
Also sounded like you were gonna get her into a horizontal position.
Mm. I mean, I wouldn't complain about
it. Did you not hear the way he was going?
It was kind of sexy.
Were you
not
feeling
that? Mind.
Were you feeling that vanilla? Oh, I see you, girl. I see you at that vanilla. It's on Dip It. With Dip It, we need you to dip your booty.
Is that twerking?
Twerking, whatever you do when you need to dip, what needs to be dipped.
I think the cameras are gonna go off. It's so
no,
big.
They will not. Have you seen mine?
I don't know how to do
5, 4, 3, 2, go.
Yes!
No!
How long will it take?
That was the fastest twerk.
That's
the first
twerk.
Time I've ever just seen the single butt cheek twerk once.
It's the old age home twerk.
That's so funny. Now, before your spilling tea days, right?
Yes, before.
You used to be a beauty queen.
Yes, primary school, high school, yes.
Oh, okay, that was a while ago.
A long time ago.
Wait, before we even get into that, I have to ask you, did you bring me something from my memento box before we get carried away?
Yes, honey.
Yo, she's pulling it out of the pocket.
Oh.
Yes! Has it been worn?
No, it's fresh, just for you.
Oh. I thought you were giving me something you want so that, you know, I can miss you guys. Well, is this your size?
I can take this one off.
Oh, yes, you should during the ad break. Is this your size?
No, though? This is your size.
Hey! No, if this was my size, it would be floss. Lelo, you also played in the space of music, right?
Yes, gospel music back in church.
Oh, really?
Like, Bina, darling.
Chama, and then why didn't you just pursue it?
You know, as a kid, I tried a lot of things. Yeah. And I just knew, okay, this is fine for me to do at home, but not for an audience. Na little Twitter can never to know. it was not for that crowd.
So was that the Agapep effect days, or was that after that?
Oh, yeah. Yes, those were the days, the Agape effect days.
Were you the Beyonce of the group?
I thought so, but I don't know if the others will agree. In my head, I was.
Yeah. So what made you decide to go off that? Were you just not interested?
No, I just actually realized, Khori, you know what? It's okay, I can sing, but not for an audience. I can't be a Beyonce and be on stage. And I'm kind of shy as well, so... Mm-hmm. You know.
Okay. Is this how Brown Sugar was born? You were like, I can find
behind
out
the
things behind the scenes.
Nobody sees my face. Yes. I can say whatever. So that was just it.
Okay, yeah. Cool. And that's when Just Curious was born.
Yes, Just Curious was born because of Brown Sugar. Brown Sugar was just this vocal, very opinionated woman that nobody knew. And then obviously people got to know me, and then the drama started.
Uh-huh. And now, like, just curious, you say you've retired from it.
Yes, we actually closed down the site. I took the decision to.
Was it guilt, or was it there's better money in Chica?
No, not even. I made more money with Just Curious than I did with Chica.
Oh, really?
Yes, I closed it down because I had just outgrown talking about people. I don't care who Bonang or whoever is dating. I just outgrew it, and I just wanted to talk about other things and not about people. Oh. And I just wanted the drama away from me. I just wanted peace.
Yeah.
Because people hated me, even for things I didn't do, because the Just Curious comments were like super crazy.
Yeah.
I'm sure you know.
Oh, yes, I did not like you for a long time. But other people...
And you did not like me for things that I did not say.
Because you were the face. You were the face of the thing that we knew.
That's exactly it.
But other people that you wish you could make up with now that it's...
Everyone, because there's never... I don't think I ever said anything on the blog that hurt anyone. It was always the comments. And people hated me because of the comments. I guess because I kind of have to take some responsibility because I provided the platform.
Yeah.
But that was not the intention. The intention was for us to have fun, and boy did we have fun.
So speaking of intentions, what is the biggest story you broke unintentionally that ended up making headlines?
Sure, I can't even think of which story it was. I just know that I would get like lawyer's letters. The first one I got was Uyanda Mbuli. Well, the first lawyer's letter I got was from her. And it was even for something I did not write. So people hate me for things I did not write. People send me lawyer's letters for things I did not write.
Oh my God.
So it was, do you understand why I quit?
I hear you.
Yes.
I hear you.
Yes.
But you also used to be part of a group of friends who, I mean, someone on your Just Curious wrote about them. This was Anele, Sizwe, Trevor, that clique.
Do you want to go there?
Right?
Because that made me delete my Twitter account.
But the funny thing is they forgave you for it, though.
Yes.
They forgave you for it.
Yes.
And did you forgive yourself? Because, I mean, by forgiving you, it was like, come back into the fold. But you never really went back into the fold.
No, because when that happened, I realized, because if you want to do gossip blogging, you cannot be friends with the very same people that are written about. Because then you can now say, no, I can't write about my friends. Or the people that write on my blog, you can't write about my friends. It's not fair. So I had to take a decision. Then you can't be friends with these guys because... where's the line?
Also, the love back are coming now, because I mean, Just Curious doesn't exist anymore.
Yeah, I think people are actually a bit more open, which is so heartwarming. People are a bit more open to me. They are okay with, which is cool, because they never needed to not be okay
so
with me.
So you could be doing Coachella with Trevor right now.
Absolutely. Trevor Vele. Trevor, we never had beef. Yeah.
Well, Anele messaged me to tell me that she loves you. She thinks you're actually brilliant and you have a great sense of humor and you're highly underrated.
Thank you. And you know what Anele said during that whole drama that made me delete my Twitter account? She was like, Lelo, it's okay, because I was asking everybody for forgiveness. And I was asking everybody for forgiveness, not for something that I did, but for something that one of my writers did.
Yes.
And she was like, Lelo, but first you have to forgive you. The very same thing that you said about you have to forgive yourself and then everything will just flow into space. So I love her too. Thank you so much for that.
Sure. Well, on that sweet note, I hope you have a sweet TVT for us, Glenn.
Thanks, Tombs. Well, the Take Me Back Tuesday this week is the Drake In My Feelings challenge. Just when we thought we'd seen them all, this video resurfaced on the interwebs to end the challenge completely. Take a look. I love how the policeman, when he approached him, then the guy sort of carried on dancing, but he sort of started dancing away from him. That's what I would do if I was arrested. I'd just dance out of it.
Speaking about dancing away from things, Lelo, 1 minute you are all over Twitter about this chocolate you have found for yourself, this
Who
man,
said it was chocolate?
You are in love. Oh, well, it sounded chocolatey the way you were tweeting. And then now you're telling us you're single.
Oh, guys, I can't tell you before I tell my Twitter followers because I broke
they
the story.
They are watching.
Okay. Okay. So what was the question again?
The question is, you are telling us there's a person you are crazy in love. Next thing you're telling us you're single.
Yeah, sadly. But it was a beautiful relationship. But you know, nothing is forever in this life.
Why? Is it because it was long distance?
How do you know that? Oh, my goodness. How do you know?
We do our homeworks.
Oh, okay. Yeah, well, yeah. That was the reason. And you know, when you start a long distance relationship, you're so in love. You don't even think what it's going to be an issue.
Yeah.
And then eventually, it was like, okay, we're not young anymore. We have to make a plan to be together. And I can't move. You can't move. So it's like, okay, bye.
So
sadly, but it was beautiful. I'm so happy it happened because I'm a sucker for love.
But now, based on your travels and a little bit in the way you walked in, is it safe to assume he's Nigerian?
No.
Okay.
I can confirm he's not Nigerian. I've actually never dated a Nigerian.
Ooh, girl, you should try West Africa.
A little birdie told us that you were hooked up by a friend.
Yes. Oh my goodness, you guys went deep in the archives. Yes, I was. So I was going to travel into his city, right? And I told my friend I'm going to be there and I don't want to be alone. And then she was like, okay, I've got this friend of mine. Here's his, she first sent me his picture on WhatsApp. And I was like, ooh, girl, yes, send me the number. So we got introduced via WhatsApp and we started talking before I got there. And the rest was a marvelous story.
So what kind of man are you into then? Is it DJs? Is it politicians? Is it businessmen? Is it comedians?
Normal people. I'm just anyone who's not trash.
Anyone.
Because you kind of have to, there's a lot of
That's
pile
gonna be
of trash that you gotta, you know, dig into to find the right one. So I'm really not, I call myself an equal opportunity lover. So.
Oh, I see you. I heard you calling him sexy. But now, you have a teenage son, right?
16, oh yeah.
Dude, I have a preteen boy. How did you handle the birds and the bees talk?
Well, as I tried to have the bees and the, what?
Birds
I
and the
don't
bees.
Even know
That's
what
why.
They are. And he was like, no, I'd rather have this conversation with my dad.
Oh, wow.
So he chose to have the conversation with his dad and the dad had the conversation. Thank goodness, because, yeah.
But if you were to give, say, Tumi advice on how, because I know already your son's starting to ask about things. So what advice would you give to her if she were to ask you how to go about it?
I think because Tumi is funny and she's a comedian, just do it with humor.
Ha! Huh?
Yes, just do it with humor. Then he feels comfortable.
Oh, yeah.
And it's not like, now we come sit down, we must talk. Then he becomes uncomfortable. But if you do it with humor, then he kind of opens up to you.
Okay.
I think so.
How do you handle your relationship dynamics though? Do you hide the guys you see from her?
Yeah, that's been one thing that I couldn't do. Just could not bring my whoever at home. So when my son is not, he's listening, so he's gonna know what happens when he's not at home.
Oh, wow.
But I try not, you know, subject him to all of that. It's very difficult because you don't know, is it gonna end tomorrow? You never know. So I try and shield him away from that as much as I can.
Sure.
Yeah.
Look, it sounds like it's rough being single and being you.
It's rough. And the other day I actually tweeted asking people, guys, single mothers, how do you date when you have got children in the house and you live with them? And it's a story that a lot of people are battling with. So
I'll
I was
tell
happy
you how.
To know.
You need to soundproof those rooms. Soundproof.
And they sneak in when the kids are sleeping.
Oh no, then there's trouble.
But also, I could also gift you a toy. You never know what's in Mama Main.
Toys don't cuddle.
That's true. We'll buy you a teddy bear and a toy. Time for another break. Melody Mulale joins us on the flip side. This is hashtag WTF to me. Let's welcome our second guest, Glenn. One district. Anyway, let's welcome our second guest. She's a fashion blogger and stylist, Melody Mulale, everyone. Madam, oh, please, shall I turn around? Let us see. Let us see. Okay, please grab a seat.
Thank you.
She's got an entire American on her dress.
Sorry, I missed the memo about the kinky gift.
The kinky? No, no,
it's just supposed to be kinky.
Why am I associated with kinkiness?
I saw a G-string coming out and yeah, I'm like, yo.
That's because Lelo kinky like that. And she's on the market, James, if you're watching. She's into the lacy G-string. Edible sometimes. Welcome, Melody. Glenn, what is Melody drinking?
Melody, your name is in tune, your style is in tune, your dancing is in tune. This drink is in tune.
Yay.
That's what I've called it. Thank you, audience.
Thank you.
Right. So while Mel grabs her drink, Twitter, can I please ask, guys, if you know that you can level up here, send us your pictures. Maybe we'll publish them before the show is over so she can pick and choose.
Wow.
Lelo is ready. Melody, on the other hand, shame you can't. She's taken, so it's too late. Melody, is this, oh, wow. Oh, so this is your, congratulations on this cosmetic deal, by the way. Well done.
Thank you so much.
Sure.
Skincare.
Yes. Also, skincare doesn't qualify as cosmetic. What?
Well, it can sometimes.
But I must specify.
That is purely skincare.
This is purely skincare.
Yeah.
So was it a lot of zeros this deal? Was it like, hey, sing or tie or isha?
Something like that.
Oh.
Something like that.
Are we talking some easy bag
or who?
Church fund small?
Somewhere in the middle, actually, very close to where some easy is.
Oh. Well, we know Gail is killing it then. So it has landed on Dare. What happens in Dare?
She's got a tweet. Have you got a have you got your phone
I
on you?
I have my phone here.
I'll get it in the meantime.
Okay, there's my phone.
So I'm gonna put this in the memento box.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's a gorgeous, compact nyana.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, man. Well done. Did you ever think that blogging would take you into this space? Like, is this a planned thing or is this a discovery that this blogging thing is a thing?
Oh, no, totally accidental. I came to Joburg from Witbank to study PR, got my PR degree, and then after working for like a year, I was like, ooh, this is not for me. So I then tried to see how I can find my feet around fashion, and then I stumbled upon blogging.
Ah.
Yeah.
But is this while you were still at Ghetto Rough? Because you touched on you did PR and
no,
people mustn't think you just did PR. You were doing PR for Ghetto Rough.
Yes, I was actually an intern at Ghetto Rough.
Ah.
I actually did not get paid at all. I was getting paid via petrol and food and whatever. I was an intern at the time.
Glenn, I know that's something. You're not an intern.
at the time when I was an intern, you're lucky to find an internship that gives you even money for petrol.
Yes.
So if you found one that paid you, ooh, congrats.
Nice. Not only did it pay her, look at her now. So the bottle has landed on Dare.
Yeah, and I've got her phone, and we're going to ask you to call your hubby.
Ooh,
and Tumi, and Tumi will speak to him.
Okay.
And,
is that soccer?
He plays soccer during the week. But let's try him out. He is saved.
Maybe
as...
then phone the Ben Dear. 10.
Okay. So Dear Husband is what is saved as. Let's see.
Speakerphone.
Is your husband supportive in your career, by the way?
Oh, absolutely. I don't think you can be in a career like this if you don't have, you know, that support structure. He is very much in agreement with what I do.
Hey, babe.
Hello.
Hey, babe, how are you?
I'm all right.
What are you wearing?
What am I wearing?
Yeah. How sweaty are you? What are you wearing? Aren't you from soccer?
I am from soccer.
So... have you hit the shower yet?
Oh,
baby, can't you hear that?
Come on! Now he's going to put my tone. He was about to answer me.
Hi, babe. What? Come on.
It looks okay, like bye, I still babe. Got it. Bye, baby. Send me a pic. DM me.
I love how he was like, yeah, but I mean, who's...
he didn't sound
he's
offended.
Like, what am I wearing?
So, listen, your Instagram, it's gold, right?
Oh, thank you.
Is the money you're making from being an influencer supporting your lifestyle? Like, I mean, you're not wearing lay-by situations here? You're wearing...
Look, I think if you are strategic enough, you can make quite a lot of money from blogging and being a social media influencer. I think a lot of people actually tend to underestimate the kind of money that's involved in it. You know?
No.
No, yeah, absolutely. I think if you... it's a pity that, you know, we don't really disclose such things, but you can make a lot of money.
She doesn't disclose. I will. I went to an event taking pictures on the red carpet for free.
Yeah.
Only to find out someone was getting paid 10 grand just to stand on the red carpet. Glenn, you're playing games here.
Yeah, playing games. I would like to ask the question, how many pictures do you take, in a sort of photo session before you decide to post the one, the special one?
Like on my phone, probably about 200.
200?
Only to post one.
To post
one. My word.
Wow. And you have so many, it's so well curated, your thing.
Thank
how, both of you guys, is there a, what's the secret to that? If I want to get more followers, I know a lot of people buy followers.
Uh-huh.
You guys don't seem like you've done that.
Uh-huh.
What is it? Is it hashtags? Do you show a bit of skin? What's the secret?
You know, I'd say that it is more consistency. So if you post once a week, post once a week.
Right.
If you post once a month, post once a month. But there needs to be some sort of a pattern that your audience is used to. And also, I think the main thing is to give out good content, good quality, and all the numbers will come after.
Right.
Yeah.
So because that's been a big debate. Don't be naked.
Yes.
Okay, I need to take
your picture will get flagged.
Wait, but when you post bikini pictures, the bikini pictures on my page get the most likes. So what is, how does
yeah,
that?
Yeah, but that's like half naked.
Oh, okay, don't be fully naked. Okay.
Full frontal.
Full frontal.
No. Okay, no.
No, look, sexy pictures, I mean, over anything will always get like
does
the
your
most
husband
attention. Look, my husband allows me to do what I desire. I don't think we would be married for this long if there was like those kind of restrictions.
Okay.
Obviously, I do it to a certain level because I work with a lot of brands that need me to, you know, be a certain way. And not to say that they are restricting me, oh, Mel, you have to be this way. But I need to be conscious of, oh, hey, baby. Oh, guys.
You have to be conscious of what you're putting out there.
You have to be conscious of what you're putting out there, you know. It has to be along your personality, who you are. Mm. I'm not a person that would be bikini, ass. I don't know if I can say that.
Ass,
you know? So I'm not that person. I wouldn't now all of a sudden change and become that person.
Well, before they charge me for being here, let's head for another ad break. When we return, we chat to our Who's That Girl guest, Baby Caramel. Stay tuned. Welcome terug na hashtag VTFE. To me, there's no date for who's that girl. This is the feature where I introduce you to a phenomenal woman that I think you should know. Tonight, I would like you to meet transgender activist, model, and singer, Baby Caramel. Grab a seat. Oh, my goodness. Now, Baby Caramel, you need to school us a little bit.
Okay.
We're gonna get straight into it. What is the difference between a transgender person, a transvestite person, and a non-binary person?
Okay, so first off, I think that we're kind of cycling transvestite out of our terminology.
Okay.
It has a lot of like negative implications.
Yeah, I thought
it kind of sounds like a slur, right?
Yeah.
So trans people and non-binary people both fall under the transgender umbrella.
Ah.
Basically, a transgender person is someone whose gender identity is not something that was perceived at birth.
Mm.
So we kind of have to state our gender to people so that people can respect us.
Okay. So it means part of the activism, I suppose, some of part of the journey to consciousness is we need to change the language. Because I think everyday people, when they're going transvestite, they're not thinking this word is problematic. We're just going, yeah, I'm showing you that I know these terminologies.
Exactly, yeah.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
And how do we respond when someone says to us, I'm transgender, or... You understand what I'm saying? Because we live, especially in South Africa, we're in a relatively conservative... We have the most open constitution, but I think we're the most conservative country.
I agree.
And so how do people... How should people respond when we meet you and you're like, hey, so I'm transgender, I'm a trans person.
Mm-hmm. What's... I think that it's about respect, you know? So I think it's really important to listen and understand. If someone tells you that their pronouns are different to what you've been referring to them as, so for example, my pronouns are she, her.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a name, so yeah. You just respect that that's what I'd like to be called.
Yes.
And I think it's just about like understanding, developing your understanding and working through your stigma or preconceived notions, just trying to be respectful because we're all trying to respect each other at the end of the day.
And is it okay if people ask? Because, you know, we live in an age where everybody just wants to understand. I think we're overdoing the wanting to understand, but can people just... ask?
Yeah, I think questions are really good, especially if they're coming from a place of understanding.
Yes.
I mean, there's a right way to ask questions, but I think if someone's asking a question to genuinely like get the right answer, then there's really no issue with that.
And I mean, in Women's Month, you know, do you feel that trans people are represented, the women especially, trans women are represented? Because I remember, was it last year that there was that whole controversy with Manducha as well?
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel, especially here?
I think across the board, like trans women, trans men, trans people aren't really represented in any real aspect or sector of South African culture.
Yeah.
So to say that we're represented and spoken for in Women's Month would be a lie.
Yeah.
I think there are more conversations happening and it's really encouraging and positive to hear those kinds of conversations being brought to the front. I just think that we can do a lot more because trans women, like women, we have our experiences and struggles, and they're just as important as the other women in the country.
Because it's not about how you came to be a woman, it's about the fact that you identify as a woman,
exactly.
Right? And speaking of identity, like, again, it's that thing of conservative country we're speaking about. And I think people get confused between gender identity and sexual preference.
Yeah.
For example, with Caitlyn Jenner, for example, when everybody went crazy on social media, when Caitlyn was like, I'm still into women, you know?
Well, I like to describe it like this. So to me, gender is like an emotion or feeling.
Mm.
So when you're happy, you can only tell people you're happy or show people you're happy with a smile.
Yeah.
And to me, that's what gender is. So I'm female and I can show you and tell you I'm female, but that's not tangible.
Yes.
Sexuality is less about my identity and more about what you see in my identity.
Ah.
So if you're into my identity, that infers your sexuality. If I'm into your identity, that infers my sexuality. But the two aren't always mutually exclusive.
Okay.
So I identify as pansexual, and that basically means that I am into anyone and everyone, irrespective of their bodies, genders, thoughts. To me, it's
about
people.
You either connect or not.
Exactly.
Oh, okay. Now, this thing of you being pan-air thing, I hear you are pan-talented as well.
Oh,
that you're not just an activist, you're not just a model, You're also a singer.
I'm not a singer. I'm a musician.
You're a musician?
Yeah.
Tell us about coitus. Don't you sing coitus?
No. Sorry.
The singers are like, listen.
No, because if I said I was a singer, people would expect me to sing, and it would just be really disappointing for everyone. No, I'm a music producer and a DJ, so I make music. Coitus is an electronic dance track. I kind of call it like a sex song for like the millennial age.
Okay.
It's like sex, but digital.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Digital coitus. The coitus impetus.
It's like, fiery.
Is it like,
yeah.
And then when we stop that music quickly, we call it coitus impetus. Oh no, coitus interruptus. Because okay, just go to your dictionaries, guys. We're vibing here. Right, Glenn, before it gets awkward, let's play A to Z.
Cool. So this game is called A to Z, guys. It's very simple. I have got a tray of letters right over here. And what I'm going to do is ask you to choose one of these letters. Each letter is linked to a word. The word is linked to a question. And you have 5 seconds to answer the question. If you do not answer the question in 5 seconds, you will down either a shot of lemon juice or tequila.
Ugh.
Are you ready?
Let the young one.
Go okay, first. The young one, are you ready, please?
Okay, we'll go with M.
Okay,
for
M, we've got M. M huh? is for.
Let's see, where do we
go? M for.
Name a cocktail.
Name a cocktail starts with the letter M. Cocktail. And action, you've got 5 seconds.
Miami cocktail, Joburg cocktail, and WTF cocktail.
Okay, we'll let you get away with that. I don't know if I've ever
said
the WTF. No,
cocktail that starts with the letter M. She's downing something.
Oh, that starts with the letter M. I was confused.
I said it so well.
I know, you did well. Okay.
Okay.
Darling, ready? And J. It's a J, ladies and gentlemen. J, we have J. And J, we have juggle. 3 things that you should not juggle. Your time starts now. 5, 4.
They don't have to start with J.
3, 2, one. That is definitely a shot.
Do you juggle everything? I have an image in my head of you juggling very inappropriate things. How can you not be thinking of things that need to be juggled?
Okay, I got confused. I thought I had to start with J.
Wow, guys, did I not explain this game?
I did say I'm in retirement.
Okay. Baby caramel.
Pick a C for caramel.
Okay. C for caramel. Okay, here's the question. Crush. Ooh. Name your top 3 crushes ever. Your time starts now.
Beyonce, Rihanna, Jennifer Lopez.
Oh, woo! Easy.
That was so quick.
Easy.
Oh, wow.
I got a tough one.
Well
Do
done.
I have to play as well?
Of course.
But guys, I'm old.
Come on.
What did I pick up? X.
X, okay.
Oh, I don't think I like this. Please, Lord.
Okay. Three X's you would call back. Ready, your time starts now.
Tabiso, Mike, Matthew.
2. You're just naming people from the Bible now.
Okay, Glenn, pick one.
Okay, D for, D, okay, here we go. Do 3 things you shouldn't do during sex.
Ooh, I like it.
Ooh.
Your time starts now.
Okay. Fart, call the person by their wrong name, or be... Oh. I was trying to think of things I have done. Okay,
Please down your shots.
Okay, between the three of us, we'll down them. Over to you, Tooms.
Right, Lelo, by the way, we've got candidates for you on the screen. Let's see. Are they not ready? Okay, down your shots while they load them. But we've got tweets.
Let's
see the tweets.
Okay.
Down your shots.
Okay, we'll share it. Okay.
Bimpy says, this show is crazy, man. It's lit. Now we get to see underwears. I've never seen one on Muvango. Says, I started watching it 10 years ago. I don't know why we've been compared to Muvango. That's so weird. Next. How long does it take at Glenn Biederman Pam to grow his beard? And I know the bastard is going to shave. How? Clearly she loves your beard.
Am I supposed, is this clapback?
No, that person loves you. They want you to keep your beard.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Okay, next.
I like being called a bastard.
After that phone call made by Ed to me, Marika, LOL, Melody's husband was like.
That's funny.
Was that the last one?
That's funny.
So future, baby caramel, what's happening? What's in the future? What's in the lineup?
I have a single coming out on the 31st of this month.
Oh, nice.
My mom and I are working on a project that I can't really speak about, but it's coming.
Oh, wow.
And a lot more things. Watch this space.
Are you going to come back and perform your new single for us, please?
I mean, if you can bring a booth in, I'll like...
A whole entire booth.
A whole booth.
We do these things all the time. And Lelo, what are your plans?
Well, my plans are really just to take care of myself. I've been feeling a little bit down recently, so I'm really looking at looking after number one.
Amen.
And not feeling guilty about doing that.
About time, we'll buy you that toy.
Number one.
Melanie.
Me.
You,
me.
Yes. Not, no, not Jacob, no. The former
He's
number,
not number one.
He's not number one anymore.
Silly Lee's number one.
Okay, so with me, I recently shot my commercial for my campaign. It launches on the 3rd of September, so please check out for it.
This is exciting times, hey, because I'm also launching a little something something on the 3rd of September, which we will talk about. So let's head out for a break. Glenn takes on TDK Makassette when we return. Hanging by the stage with TDK Makassette.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for TDK Makassette. or should I say Gom Barbie? Is that what?
Yes, it's Gom Barbie.
Is actually. That just like a sub name?
Something like that.
A sub nickname. your performance was incredible. I'm sorry, I usually dance to the performance, but I was kind of mesmerized by your dancing. Where did you learn those dance moves?
To be quite honest, I think it just comes naturally because I don't really plan anything that I do. So yeah, it's just like a surprise. Every single day, like when I look at my door, because I mean, I cram sometimes I don't. So it just comes naturally.
Okay, now I want to get into the nitty gritty here because there's Babes Would Do More. I know you're bored of it. I know, but the fans need to know. What is the story? Who wrote it, the song? Who wrote it? What happened? Please explain.
All I could tell you
is
that get your phone, Google TDK Makassette on iTunes, Google Play, Deezer, and everything, and you'll just see my song. So I feel like I've got nothing else to explain but just to say that.
Okay, so there's no beef?
I've got no beef with anyone.
You guys are cool?
If you can put it that way, yes, we're definitely cool.
Okay, I'm looking to get some beef with someone. How, if I wanted to get beef, how do I do that?
Steal someone's song.
Wow. So it's not true that she won't share the stage with you?
Oh, no, I'd love to actually work with her.
Okay.
I'd like to work with everyone else, but I mean, I've got no beef with anyone. I just feel like, hence I always say, let's respect each other's craft and let's move forward. I mean, there's so much that we could do together, definitely.
I would love to see that. There's also this headline. It says, DJ Mapurista, I walk... Iwalk Yapara wasn't stolen. It's the new Iwalk. Get
yes,
it out in your eye stores. TDK Makassette claims are laughable. So it's the laughable quote.
Or is it?
No, what do you think of that? What brought about all that confusion?
I don't know. You tell me.
Well, you know what? I have no bloody idea. Well, the air is clear.
It's not important, so let's just, you know.
Should we call Mapurista now and just see if everything's okay?
He's sleeping.
Maybe him and... Okay, and the album, can we speak about the album?
Oh, yes, I'm definitely dropping an album next year. It's crazy. I can't wait for it. I'll be working with a whole lot of people. And I'm also dropping my single end of September.
Sheepers.
First week of October with OK Madam Cool Cat. And I'm also having a launch next week, Thursday, the Gom Barbie.
Wow.
So people must just look out for all the information on my Instagram page and my Facebook and my Twitter. So no beef, you know, my police are
beef for
everything
what? Beef for who? I like that. I'd like to challenge you on a feature we call Can You Dance Better Than Glenn? Basically, it's a dance-off. I'm going to go first. I'll show you how it's done.
First.
You want to go first?
I'm joking.
Okay, I'll go first. Are you ready?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, let's hit it. Okay.
Oh, right here. After doing that,
ladies, it's over you to you to decide if she can or cannot dance better than Glenn.
She can.
Okay, that's one vote.
Absolutely.
She can. That's two votes.
Three votes.
Three votes. To yes. me, please. I mean, you know what?
I give it to you, baby. You brought it. You didn't even pull stunts. She was breaking things. Yeah. You were just all body. All body. Well, a big thanks to our guests, Lelo Boyana, Melody Molale, and Baby Caramel. Next week, Monday, we're having a pajama party with Lerato Moloi and Sonia Sidibe. Sexpert Jade Zwane will be in studio to answer all your sexual health related questions. So make sure you send us questions of things you're curious about sexually via Twitter at WTF Timmy. From myself and Glenn, good night.